If you ever saw Julie Campbell, you'd never guess. She just lost about everything.
It's gone. Yeah, it's gone.
Julie lost her home in the campfire. Tonight, she says she took a break from the tragedy by going to a holiday event she's loved for decades with a friend.
It's a lot. I haven't been here since my children were little, so this is a big night for me.
So when they learned Christmas in the park was forced to close a week early, they were disappointed. And
it's my baby, you know, so of course I'm going to be a little disappointed.
They're not the only ones. Even Christmas in the Park executive director Jason Minsky felt the same when he learned the college football playoff championship game wanted to take over the park before the big game at Levi's the first week of January.
We went through some negotiations and decided to kind of be a community player here, so we're going to make the sacrifice this year, close down a little bit early.
But because Thanksgiving was also a week early, Christmas in the Park isn't actually losing any days. What the nonprofit organization is losing, however, is revenue, according to Jason, because the week after Christmas is typically one of its busiest times.
There's still going to be some disappointed people. We understand that, but hopefully they understand that it's just a one-time thing, and then we'll be back full force and even bigger next year.
I don't like sports, so, you know, it's a shame to lose this over that.
Jason says next year, when the event celebrates its 40th anniversary, they'll be open 40 days. Call it a Christmas gift next year for those who feel a little gypped this holiday.
The challenge for organizers is getting all this cleaned up in 5 days. Typically, they have 2 weeks, but football game organizers have agreed to pay for extra crews to get it done. On the Night Beat, I'm Maria Medina.
Now, there's no official projection on how much the city of San Jose stands to make on the BCS championship, but the big game brought in more than $60 million for host city Atlanta last year, and that's twice what San Jose took in during Super Bowl 50.